I mean, I do think, I didn't think we started the game with the kind of aggressiveness that we wanted to play with tonight. And we're still learning a lot about these guys, trying to figure out. I've said to you guys for a long time now, there's not a big gap between any one of these guys. And you see the minutes were spread out there. But the first thing we're going to have to learn to do is play as hard as we can. And I think they realize it's really hard to play hard for 2.5 minutes the way we need to play. We weren't great offensively. I thought we turned down shots that we had to take, rhythm shots. They were playing somewhat of a sagging, sloppy man-to-man, you know, trying to get us to shoot the ball. And I want to shoot the ball. I mean, we work hard at shooting. I think we've got a group of guys that can shoot it. But we didn't rebound the ball, and that's the one thing we talked about, the way we need to. We need to look at it. We knew they were going to be aggressive. That's what they do. They put it up, and their thought process is that's when the game is on. And they did a good job getting that part of it done. But we had some good things from different guys, and I thought when guys were called on, for the most part, they would play with the kind of energy that we need.
It plays in the game, something's happening, whether it's good or bad. I guess is it just a matter of him playing under control on both sides, or kind of what is key for him?
Well, he's a guy that we think that he's a game changing kind of player. He can come in and bring some energy, and he's done a good job. He did a couple of things that he hasn't done on the offensive end. Like he took a tough shot at the top of three, basically standing on the 3-point line, and I think that goes back to fatigue. He likes to play hard. He can play hard, but he and Volpe. I mean, those guys when they came in here, it's two games in a row. They really brought some energy, both of those guys, and just playing all out and somewhat with reckless abandon, and that's what we wanted to do.
You had two different combinations of teams out there. Based on this, have you figured out when you start grinding big, you get the 6 or 7 man to be on the bench?
Yeah, we told the team that at halftime. We haven't. I think it's easy to start who we're going to start. I don't think that's big. I actually told them this last night. I wouldn't be so concerned about who starts, but who's going to finish games. But the rotation, getting closer, but I don't think we've got it figured out yet. And I'm not sure how long it will take, because we're going to play a lot of people. I mean, that's obvious. We've got the numbers, and we want to force tempo. We want to play with a lot of energy, and so we're going to use these guys. I think in a regular game, I look at the numbers here. You know, Roberts was obviously played more minutes than he played tonight. He played 11 minutes. I mean, that's, he'll probably play 13 more. So he's going to probably be a 24, 25 minute game player. He'll lead us in minutes. But again, we're still to answer that question. I don't think we've got anything quite figured out yet.
That may preempt my question. I was going to ask you what was the most disconcerting thing about tonight. I mean, it was an impressive score, a turnover margin for sure, but were you thinking you might have some things figured out after this game?
No, I think we're too young. What we do have figured out is that we've got a good group of guys, and we've got a good team spirit about us. They're starting to understand, play hard. That's non-negotiable, and it's not a thing. We're still trying to forge that work ethic every single day. Again, what we didn't do today, and we didn't take shots that we needed to take when we were open, and some of that had to do with the first time playing in front of people. But overall, there was the effort. I mean, and some guys, I still think will have to show us a little bit more effort too. But we took care of the ball. That was a game where we were playing quick and fast, but we weren't real smooth offensively.
Steve, then West, and Ray. You're out rebounded by 9, but you have 13 blocks. Just in general, how do you feel about your inside play, and how far does that need to come going into the game?
Well, I thought that, again, I think everything we do has got a long way to go to get there, but I think we're heading I thought they, for the most part, worked hard to keep it out of the post, and we got some really good backside rotation. The blocks are there, but I'm not sure. It's, do you have any stats? How many charges? We took a number of charges, which is equivalent to a block. We know we have to do that. We know we've got some warm inside there. But, again, it was a second, third attempt rebound is what we weren't coming up with. And some of that had to do with length and bounce, you know, second and third bounce. But it also has to do with our guards coming down, coming up with some of those loose balls that are getting batted around.
You talked about the energy that Fulkerson and Parker brought. Is that something that you saw from them when you were recruiting them? Or is that something that really kind of emerged in practice here?
Well, you've seen it from John. I mean, John is a guy that can run the floor, and he's playing harder than he's ever played. I mean, he's never played as hard as he's played the last two times. I'd actually, a week ago maybe, I told him that he was a fifth post player. And he responded and had two good days of practice and played really, really well. What you saw him tonight, he was the most energized guy Saturday and came in and did some things. And tonight, I think he was the first seven to put in on the post because he earned that. And he didn't disappoint us. He plays hard. And I mean, I've never coached a guy that can sprint to the scorer's table as quick as he does in the game. He wants to play. And he took himself out a couple times, and I think that's the start of understanding what you have to do. I mean, he played hard enough to get tired, where I don't think he ever did that in high school, probably. But yeah, we saw the fact that he's a guy that's going to get his hands on balls. He's going to rebound the ball. He's going to, and he can run. He's really good out in the floor. He can finish. He's a better low post player than he gives himself credit for. But he's starting to, I mean, he's just getting started out good player he can be. And Quay is a guy that when we look at him, the way he's playing is exactly, I don't know if he played totally that way, but we looked at him as being a guy that could eventually become like a little gnat there on defense, just bothering people, just letting them feel him and let them know that he's there.
Are you surprised that John's picked up on the effort part of it this quickly? And also, what gives Jordan the advantage over Lamonte at this point, or just him playing first?
I would say, what was that first question?
On Fulker, are you surprised?
Am I surprised at John? I was probably more surprised early because, you know, we think he's a tough worker, you know, a tough hard-nosed guy. He doesn't get rattled. You know, he takes coaching extremely well and bounces back. He's one of those guys that has, I think, a short memory. You know, he'll listen, and he doesn't go in a shell when you get on him. But I do think he took to heart what I told him. Right now you're a fifth post player, and, you know, he had some moments early, and then he kind of, early in the year, you know, he was playing really well. He and Grant, and all at once, Kyle kind of took it to another level, and Adam took it to another level, Lou took it to another level, and he and Grant kind of didn't bite back, and they went back. And I thought Grant was much, much better tonight than he was Saturday. And John played tonight very, very similar to how he played in the scrimmage series. What did Grant play tonight? 15 minutes. Of Grant played six more minutes than he played Saturday. And I thought, if you look at what he did, And he was the one guy right before the game I signaled out and said that we're going to see if you're going to improve on what you did last time out. He did.
Coach, you mentioned back here, you mentioned effort. What else were you looking for out of your freshman tonight, and did they succeed in that matter?
Execution. You know, the details and offensively. I thought we moved the ball, but I don't think we were making scoring cuts. I don't think we were setting scoring screens. I don't think we were getting down looking for cutters, and again, they were sagging off, and we had chances to come off and put the ball there and raise up and shoot shots if we practiced. We didn't do that, and we ran, you know, we didn't do a lot of what we can do, but we were looking for more in transition than we probably got tonight. And, but like I said, there were some good things, and yet there's a lot of work left to be done.
Last one right here with class.
I think a lot of people from the outside would see such a young team and wonder, you know, if them going faster is, you know,
know, what you want necessarily, but how tough can it be as a coach to, you know, ask kids that are young to play really fast because they might make more mistakes if they're doing that?
Well, we practice faster than we play, and that was one thing that came out of the scrimmage. Those guys felt like the game had really slowed down based on the tempo that we go with, and I think, again, asking them to play fast, and they don't know how to play fast. They always say they want to get out and run and play, but think about it. I took guys out tonight for not shooting the ball. And I don't think as a player you could ask anything more than the coach to say, we hope to shoot the ball. And even when you miss them, you got to still take your shots because we've got rebounding set up where guys, you shoot the ball, that allows a guy like John Fulkerson, it allows a guy like Grant, Kyle to go get it. And but even those guys early didn't fight for the ball the way they need to. And the playing fast is, we want to play, I don't know if I'd say it fast as much as I say quick. We want to be quick and we want to be sharp. We just don't want to be in a hurry. And tonight at times we were a little bit hurried.
Coach, thank you.
Thank you, guys.